Hello, we are discussing prayer today. I'm Wilbert Watkins. Everyone's heard of prayer, and perhaps you've heard or recited a standard prayer like the Lord bless you and keep you and give you peace. Amen. Sometimes we hear prayers about people. Other times we hear prayers about things. I've often heard individuals say that they don't know how to pray. And perhaps the best way to start a prayer is to begin it with gratitude. Because all of us can think of people or things in our lives that are important to us. As we begin this Lenten season, I'd like to encourage you to take some time each day to pray for gratitude. It's easy to get caught up in the busyness of our lives and to forget to thank God for all the blessings that we have. So let's take a few moments to reflect on the importance of gratitude and how it can enhance our lives. And I'm going to encourage us to do that as we listen to a song.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing Your song.
That song is a great reminder of all the reasons that we need to have to be grateful and to bless the Lord. As we reflect on unique ways that God has shown God's love, this song also encourages us to practice gratitude, not only as a way of thinking, but as a way of being. Let's pray. Loving God, in hearing this beautiful song, we are reminded of the many reasons we have to be grateful and to bless Your holy name. We thank You for all the unique ways that You show Your love for us. Help us to cultivate a spirit of gratitude each and every day. Amen. So, using language that's comfortable for you, because God wants us to be authentic, let's share a prayer of gratitude. I'll start. I'll say something, someone that I'm thankful for, and then I'd like for you to say something right where you are that you're grateful for. I'm grateful for you. I'm grateful for the comfort of home. I'm grateful for the breath in my body. I'm grateful for my church home. And now, God, we put all of these blessings together in a simple prayer that we give to You in gratitude. Amen. I'm going to share a verse of scripture, Psalm 107, verse 1, that says, "Give thanks to God, for God is so good, whose love endures forever." This verse is a reminder that God's love is always present and that we should be thankful for it. You know, during the Lenten season, it's often easy to feel sad, to think about the S word, sin, to think about the bad things in the world, where we have failed others when we've had bad thoughts or have bad actions or behavior. And I'd like to lighten the mood for just a moment, since I brought all of that up, and share a joke with you. Why did the tomato turn red? Because it saw the salad dressing. Now, perhaps you laughed at that. Perhaps you rolled your eyes. Perhaps you just thought, that's silly. Whatever happened, I hope you relaxed for a moment. And I hope you realize that this is a time to let it go. And again, be thankful. So let's get back to our reflection. Gratitude is not just about saying thank you for all the good things in life, but it's also about acknowledging the challenges that we have and that we face, recognizing the strength that God will give us to overcome them. As we journey through Lent, we may face temptations. We probably will face temptations, struggles, and difficult decisions. However, if we approach these challenges with gratitude and can find the strength in our faith and trust that God will guide us through it all, we will be the better for it. Now let's take a moment to think about our blessings. It could be anything, a person, a place, a moment, a possession. Think about how that blessing has impacted your life and how your blessing has brought you joy. Take a few moments to thank God for it. Again, I'd like to share a song as we're thinking about what we want to thank God for.
I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
A beautiful reminder of God's goodness.
'Cause all my life you have been faithful.
And God's faithfulness.
And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire, and in darkest night you are close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God.
Songs like this can be wonderful tools for cultivating gratitude and appreciation for the unique ways that God shows God's love. Unique ways that we don't think about, perhaps, our breath, our family, our friends, our good health, a safe home, a job, food, education, sleep, transportation, technology, music. Let's pray. God, we thank you for all the blessings in our lives. We thank you for the people who love us, for the places we call home, for the moments that bring us joy, and for the possessions that make our lives a little easier. We also thank you for the challenges that we face, as they remind us of the strength that we have from you and our reliance on you. Help us to approach this Lenten season with gratitude and to always remember that your love endures forever. Amen. Before you go, praying for gratitude is an essential part of our Lenten journey. It helps us to remember the good in our lives, to acknowledge our challenges, and to trust in God's love. I'm encouraging you to take a few moments each day to reflect on what you're thankful for and to thank God for all the blessings in your life. And I thank you for joining me today, and I wish you a blessed Lenten season filled with gratitude and praise.